Yeah, I'm making another Looney Tunes video right after I made the Elmer Fudd video. Well, I have a reason. Right after that video, I got multiple people giving some good insight that I didn't include. And while everyone and their mom is making iceberg videos, I never see videos about Looney Tunes. People just want to talk about stupid Steven Universe.
What the hell is that?
But that means I gotta do research. And bruh, I don't want to do that. So like the true Redditor I am, I posted the empty iceberg for help, and one guy, my savior, replied with a detailed list. So some of these are mine, and some of these are his. Special thanks to DazzyFan100. So let's get right into the iceberg. Spinoffs. These are shows like Sylvester and Tweety Mysteries, that one Taz show, Tiny Toons, and baby Looney Tunes. My god, I hate it so much. I just want to grab baby Bugs and curb stomp his head. This could also include stuff like these compilation series like The Porky Pig Show and the Bugs and Daffy Show. Just riveting names. What if they did this with like an obscure character, like the Buddy Show? Yeah, I can't wait to watch that. But these are kind of weird, not really spin-offs. There's Duck Dodgers, which I've only heard of recently. Apparently it's pretty good, and it has Marvin the Martian, the most unappreciated guy ever. So 10 out of 10. General audiences. Surprisingly, Looney Tunes is just not for kids. Yeah, I know, a huge shocker. I mean, everyone finds violence funny, and if you don't, then you're not funny. DVD movies. There's compilation movies, but, you know, that's exactly what you think it is. It's just a series of shorts. There's some original straight-to-DVD movies, which are usually just some character going on an adventure and the other guys are just showing up, I guess. It's kind of weird how the Tom and Jerry movies are more prevalent. I mean, that's just straight-up slapstick, but they find a way. Oh, do they sure find a way? I just read the back of this movie, Rabbits Run, and it sounds pretty insane. It's like an all-out brawl to get a perfume or something with Sam, Elmer, and the Foghorn Leghorn as the villains. Oh, okay.
You see me sitting on...
2 likes, and I'll review it. I mean, come on, it sounds better than Space Jam. Oh yeah, speaking of Space Jam, I think I only watched it like one time, and I don't remember anything. Like, I know the plot, I think. Do I really have to care about this movie where this happens? It's mostly weird basketball, and then the Looney Tunes just don't fit in. This movie is just a marketing ploy, so...
Pebble Beach!
This is no way for a pampered superstar to travel!
What the shoes?
And they're all mine!
Give me those Air Jordans!
No! Yes! No! Yes! No! Yes! No! No! Yes! No! Yes! No! Take these or else! That makes me angry!
I'm gonna spend my time talking about Space Jam 2, a skit made by Fried Chili Cheese Dogs. It's absolutely a work of art. Like I think I've actually remembered every line. Yeah, so it's a great and funny skit. Too bad all the videos got deleted and only one remains. Looney Tunes Back in Action was a movie that I might have watched, but I forgot everything. I can only describe this movie as Who Framed Roger Rabbit, but worse. Well, that actually already exists.
A hedgehog? Wait, hedgehogs can't talk?
Oh, but do they dance?
It is better than Space Jam from what I remember. The tunes feel like themselves, and These two people are okay, but I don't really care. This museum scene is so good, and it should be hung in a museum itself. Also, for some reason, I really enjoy when the Roadrunner and Coyote shorts are shown to be connected, because most of the time, they're just, you know, doing their own thing. Overall, it's pretty good. Oh yeah, and this scene with Shaggy was pretty...
What gives, Doc? We made 35 pictures together.
Well, as it turns out, I'm secretly evil.
The Looney Tunes show was a soft reboot. Most of the characters have the same general personality. But now it's all of them in a sitcom. Kind of. It's the Looney Tunes characters living in a city, going on adventures, but not anything insane. It's just like Bugs taking off his gloves or something. But there's also the occasional Cecil the Turtle with a gun. In my opinion, this is the best Looney Tunes reboot kind of show. And yes, it's because I'm biased. I watch this one a lot. And new Looney Tunes gives me hemorrhoids, I'm sorry. They also did a Merry Melodies series and a weird Coyote CGI thing, but I'm not gonna put that in their own separate entries. They're part of the same show. The Merry Melodies one, of course, brought us the Grilled Cheese song. And a really underrated Daffy song that is so good, and the animators just go so hard for no reason. Big Chungus. A lot of people know about him. I don't know where the name came from, but it's a frame from Wabbit Trouble. Nowadays, it's just used to make fun of Reddit and stuff like this.
Zit-jaga, zit-jaga, yata-jaga.
Although I don't know how it got connected to Reddit, but I guess it's a r/chonkers thing or something. I don't know. And yes, the Looney Tunes show had an episode where Bugs got fat, which means he will always live on. Golden Collection is a really cool Looney Tunes DVD collection that I totally want to own. That's about it, but it's a pretty neat design. New Looney Tunes was a reboot, kinda. The animation is fine. I'm not actually that against it, but some characters look weird, like Elmer and Coyote, but you know, people who actually watched it probably got used to it. It's fine. But I also have to mention this show was Wabbit, a show about Bugs and some squirrel literally no one knows about. So yeah, it got changed into New Looney Tunes early on. And I think I know why. The original series was called Wabbit, which is based on how Elmer Fudd says rabbit, but he's not even in the show! One-shot characters are guys who only show up in the background or... really only for a short. I don't really know where to put this one. Like, you can't name any of these guys, but they aren't important. I mean, I'm not gonna put a grain of sand seen in this shot in the abyss because it's obscure. HBO Max refers to the Looney Tunes cartoons airing on, well, HBO Max. This is the newest version of the show, and it's a return to the old.
Oh, no you don't! Can't you read the sign?
It's all cool and all, but where are my guns? Yeah, all the guns are gone, and I really don't care. I did recently watch it, and some of these plots, there's really no need for guns, so there's really no reason to care. What I really want to know about is why they, like, slightly changed the character design. It's mostly color, but, like, why? I don't really see why. I do like how Daffy is finally an epic troll like he was made to be. This series is pretty alright, but I don't have HBO Max. The 90s shorts are mostly unknown. Like, name one of them. 1-3, okay, time's up. There was also, like, barely any. Not many people talked about them because they're not really that interesting, and the popularity of Looney Tunes was based on this. It's not controversial like the new Looney Tunes or the no guns thing. It's not a classic like the original series. They're just kind of there. original slash new Porky design is referring to when Porky looked like this. And I gotta say, I'm not fond of this design at all. The shorter design just works better. If this was the design that was poking out its head and saying, "That's all, folks," I would want to protect myself with a firearm. The best way I can explain this is that I should be able to beat Porky in a fight. This one could kill me. And strangely, they brought this design back for new Looney Tunes. Well, now it's time to put that on the list for reasons not to watch this. Right next to... Yeah, I don't know why they decided to bring this design back. I'm sure not a lot of people really wanted this, but... Yeah, sure, I don't really care. Wabbit Season is a short made by the YouTuber Meat Canyon. I don't really think this belonged up here, but I put in Big Chungus. So now I have to talk about it. It's just your average cartoon, but... Uh-oh, it's dark parody. Bugs is LGBT. Bugs is LGBT. I mean, he keeps on dressing up like a girl and doing this stuff. I'm sorry, Bugs. But this isn't an epic troll. Also, I guess this is considered a theory. Racism. Just gonna dive right into that. It's no secret... Some old Looney Tunes cartoons were extremely racist because, let's be honest, everything was back then. It's not a great look, but I like Warner Bros. Taking full responsibility while Disney is acting like it never happened. Acme. Acme is the corporation that provides Wile E. Coyote a bunch of tools to kill Roadrunner, like sponsors, sending the YouTuber stuff to review. Please sponsor me, Eminem. I do want to talk about this one more, but... There's really nothing to say. Its name are seen on other products out of the Coyote shorts, so I guess they just sell everything like Walmart. There's a game where I think it's important. It's in the name, so it better be important. Oh yeah, all these products are awful and don't work. I guess it really is like Walmart. Bosco was one of the first reoccurring Looney Tunes characters, and the best part? He's a monkey! This guy is like completely forgotten. At least Oswald the Lucky Rabbit came back. Poor Bosco was lost to time. But then I found Bosco on DeviantArt, so yeah, let's just forget about him. Propaganda. During World War II and probably, you know, some other stuff, many animation studios made propaganda to help recruit for America and stuff like that. We got everything in these. Violence, Hitler, and more racism. Warner Bros. Made some as about what you would expect. Looniacs Unleashed was an action cartoon featuring reboots of the Looney Tunes. And yes, I'm not watching it. It doesn't look good, but like, I'm not watching it. Do I still get complaining rights? It's not even that they changed the art style to look like Bargain Bin Ben 10, but all these characters look the same. They're all wearing the same thing. Why are these two on the same team? If they can be on the same team, then why isn't Sylvester here with Tweety? Where's my man Elmer Fudd? Ah! Cameos. I don't know if you know, but the Looney Tunes are pretty famous. So of course they're gonna have some cameos. So now I'm gonna list all the ones I at least know. Cartoon Network bumpers. And hey, this one is an edited Elmer Season gag. Gremlins 2, Animaniacs, both versions. Who Framed Roger Rabbit? That one is obvious. And my favorite cameo, Angry Video Game Nerd. This one doesn't count, but I don't care. Oh my God! Daffy No Beak. This happens other times, but usually during the duck season joke. When Daffy is shot, his entire beak falls off with no blood. This gives horrible implications. That means it was attached on. And you want to know who Daffy kind of looks like while he has no beak? That's right. Marvin the Martian. Is Daffy actually a Martian? No. But for real, this is terrifying. Space Jam 2 leaks. This may be outdated probably when this video comes out. But the plot and some screenshots were leaked to Space Jam 2. These pictures show characters like The Mask, Pennywise, Joker, and the Wicked Witch of the West, basically making this the weirdest movie ever made. Well, when it's actually made. The leaked plot said that the Looney Tunes are back and they're going up against all these Warner Bros. Villains with the help of LeBron James. Man, am I gonna have to watch the first one to get the plot in this one. You know what this movie is missing? Hagrid from Harry Potter.
Everybody get up, it's time to slam.
You're a wizard.
We got a real jam going down. Welcome to the Space Jam. Here's your chance, dude.
Invasion of the Bunny Snatchers is a short I really enjoy. It starts with Bugs going through his normal routine with the rest of his foes. But the next day, they've all been like assimilated into weird, badly drawn knockoffs. Looks like I've left the best Elmer Fudd out of my last video.
Charlie Brown.
Drugs, alcohol, and sex.
It also shows that there's like more hunters trying to get Bugs and Daffy. Is there like a warrant for them? It's built this reputation of being disturbing. I mean, the entire idea of the short is creepy, but you got Daffy full bullet holes and fake bugs trying to kill real bugs with an axe. Yeah, it's pretty bad. But there was a Tom and Jerry cartoon where they killed themselves.
Suicide is badass.
Yeah, it's on edge, but it's not like extremely disturbing. I just enjoy the plot. It's a nice change of pace.
Get me out of here. Cut me loose. Cut me the hell. Come on, get me out of here. Come on, get me out of here. Cut me loose, damn it.
Video games. So, of course, it's gonna have a lot of games. There was a bunch of games for the NES, where I'm pretty sure every single one of them just starred Bugs. They just find it hilarious that they made 5 crazy castle games. Like, how and why? There was some games released during the PS2 and GameCube era. Acme Arsenal was some weirdo shooting game where Foghorn Leghorn has a gun.
3, 2, 1, oh, oh.
And I've actually bought and played the Looney Tunes Back in Action game, and yes, the cutscenes all combined together is a better movie.
Huh? Well, that wasn't supposed to happen.
I haven't played throughout the entire thing yet, but it's pretty good. It's a platformer where you switch between Bugs and Daffy. Daffy controls pretty well. Of course, you barely play as him. It's all about Bugs! It's a collect-a-thon, so yeah, there was parts where I had no idea what to do. It's pretty annoying. I mean, one of the problems was so universal that if you looked it up, multiple people would have the same question. From what I've seen, these extras are pretty cool, and here's some more Elmer Fudd stuff. There's this Elmer Fudd-like character who starts strangling you once you get near him. He has a gun. He isn't gonna use it, I guess. But this guy is an Elmer? His only name is Security Guard. Elmer does show up as a boss, though. You better study this for FUD class. This is very important. Porky swearing. A clip from an old Looney Tunes cartoon became semi-popular. I can only explain it with itself.
Oh, son of a bit, son of a bit, son of a bit, gun. You thought I was gonna say son of a bitch, didn't you?
I just love everything about this. The fact that Porky literally just breaks his own rules and says it anyways is pretty funny.
What the f***? How many f*** is shot point blank? What the f***? Holy bitch f***ing Christ, dude!
Porky Murder. This is referring to the Looney Tunes show episode Murder. I wonder who this episode is about. Daffy spends the day at Porky's and then is convinced he's a murderer. You know, basic confusion plot. It's down here because of how dark it is. Porky's doing stuff that looks like murder but isn't. Near the end of the episode, Daffy tries to escape Porky and it's pretty brutal, man. Yeah, Looney Tunes is finally bringing back what made it popular. Brutality. Like, this is a weird sitcom show, and it's reacted as actual injuries. People are shot in these cartoons with only mild face falling off. In this episode, Porky falls down some stairs like Mr. Glass. And yes, it's kind of annoying that Daffy's never punished, and this isn't the best episode, but I enjoyed it. There's some pretty good jokes.
And I'm jumping to an outlandish conclusion because I'm a paranoid, hateful fear-mongerer? No, that's the face of a killer.
In the end, it's revealed Porky was just planning Daffy's birthday party. And also, the murderer that Daffy thought was Porky looks like this. Wait a minute. That's the security guard! I knew it was him! It all makes sense!
He was number one!
He strangled them all! Ah! Ralph and Sam, you're probably looking at these two characters and thinking, that's Sam Sheepdog, and that's Wile E. Coyote. Well, that's actually Ralph Wolf. But you can't tell when they look exactly the same. Sam over here looks like he did a ton of steroids, like Jesus Christ, and fake Coyote here only has like one feature that separates these two, his nose looking like Ronald McDonald.
Take along a friend and grab a hold of Ronald's hand.
These shorts are very close in style to the Coyote shorts. It's what you expect. Sam has to stop Ralph from eating the sheep. So again, we get the classic assault. And another few characters added to the Looney Tunes back in action restaurant scene. The Looney Tunes have had some park appearances, mostly in Six Flags, and I have no idea why Universal has done barely anything. They gotta save space for the god-awful, like, Fast and Furious ride. At Six Flags, there's a couple roller coaster. Yo, hold up. Is that a Foghorn Leghorn statue? Okay, I have to go buy a ski mask. There should be some dark ride, like that one Cat in the Hat ride that gives me nightmares. Also, you know, one that doesn't look like this. Roadrunner ran into Medusa or something, because that boy ain't going anywhere. Coyote looks like he's about to jump scare me. Oh my god, never mind. I'm sorry, buddy. You know, the guy who made this animatronic was actually calling out for help. Porky will slaughter us all. Wait, is there actually a story to this ride? Well, I gotta study this to become a true Looney Tunes lore historian. So Yosemite Sam is doing something illegal, Speedy is desolate, and whatever Sam was gonna do, I guess Bugs stopped it. Rocking chair. I put this in as a joke because someone replied with it after seeing my iceberg image, but I mean, it's a justified entry. Don't put it in. Bugs versus Wile E. There was a couple cartoons that pinned Bugs and Wile E. Coyote against each other. It's basically the same format as the Roadrunner cartoons, but with Bugs. I didn't even know this existed. I better watch some of these.
Oh, you're staying for lunch, all right. You are lunch.
As much as I don't like Coyote talking, I mean, this is exactly what I thought he would sound like. Yeah, I know he also talks in other stuff, but like barely. It's also weird how Coyote is branded as a genius of trickery. It's funny to think of him as this character that thinks so highly of himself, even though this happens all the time. Also, he's British. That's pretty,
What kind of wine would be good with wild game? You are game, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm British!
Mel Blanc's tombstone. Mel Blanc was the voice actor of many major Looney Tunes. Some cartoons had, like, a list of a bunch of characters. Voice actor list would just be him. His tombstone reads out, "That's all, folks." It's kind of morbid, isn't it? That phrase has a totally different context now. I think he used it a lot, so I can see why it's here. CGI shorts. During a short amount of time, some Looney Tunes shorts were released in the style of the originals, but animated in CGI. It's kind of similar to the Peanuts movie, I guess. I think it looks good. They're pretty well animated, surprisingly. They're just shorts, and barely anyone brings them up, so I would expect them to look like this.
Bugs Bunny!
But nope, they're pretty good. More Jam movies. After the success of Space Jam, Warner Bros. Was like,
"We've got to have..."
They started working on stuff like Spy Jam, Race Jam, and Skate Jam, three movies that would basically be the same concept as Space Jam, with a star being the main character of the movie, but I have no idea what happened to these movies. They were all canceled, maybe someone slipped and deleted all the files or something. Spy Jam sounds like it was repurposed for Back in Action, but I'm pretty sure that was just an evolved idea from the director. But he probably took inspiration. Just two movies down the drain. Huh? What's this? That's right. I got the secret footage from Spy Jam, baby. Let's see what's in here.
I have never known such helpless sadness.
Censored 11. These are cartoons that are banned from airing for being horribly racist. These are different from your average racist cartoon. These are like super racist. They're not lost, but just banned. You can find them on YouTube if you're really interested in, well, this. There's not really much to say. I could go over some of them, but it's just a bunch of blackface. Private Snafu was a series of propaganda cartoons starring this guy, Private Snafu. Since it was shown to recruit potential military workers, it had a similarity with other World War II propaganda. There's not much to say that I haven't already said in the propaganda entry, to be honest.
He's sailing on a troop ship. Now we got to find out.
Once you see it, you can never unsee it. Welcome to WatchMojo.com.
TGT stands for Tales Gets Trolled, a webcomic where a bunch of different copyright characters kill internet trolls. This probably sounds like some stupid fanfiction, but I swear, it gets so deep that it's actually the best thing ever. Many of the characters come from Looney Tunes, with Bugs and Daffy being gay. Yep, I told you. Best comic ever. And then they get shot. So later on, Coyote, Elmer Fudd, Sylvester, and Tom, even though he's not a Looney Tune, who cares, show up. But they have magic necromancy powers, so they can use corpses as puppets, and Coyote gets in a 3-chapter-long battle with an edgy demon guy. And yes, I didn't read a plot synopsis. I read the entire thing. Absolute masterpiece. You Ought to Be in Pictures is a cartoon that has the characters show up with a bunch of the animators and directors. It's like one of the first live-action animation mashup. I think it's pretty cool. Look at this guy drawing Porky. Hey, this must be the perfect tutorial. Now I can draw Porky just like this guy. Okay, let's start here. Just do a little speed run. Let me start my... Okay, and... Okay, it looks pretty good. Egghead. I'll go over this quickly since I basically covered everything from my last video. This was the beta version of Elmer Fudd. He was a weird little guy that sometimes had a bowl cut. He's pretty interesting because while evolving into Elmer Fudd, he actually reappeared a couple times, so he isn't Elmer Fudd, even though he is.
It could be in this very room. It could be you. It could be me. It could even...
Fudd Figmansky. I'll get into that name in a bit, but here's an update to that last video. There was a brief period where Elmer Fudd was super large, and this was famously in Wabbit Twubble, the cartoon that brought us Big Chungus.
What?
No, alright, I know that sounds bad.
In that video, I said this was just a weird style change, and this large guy was the same guy as Elmer Fudd. But when sharing the video on Discord, someone said that the fat Elmer was introduced as a guy named Fudd Figmansky in Tweety and Sylvester Mysteries. Yeah, this is kind of shocking to me. Like, why bring back this design as a different character? It's basically the same thing that happened with Egghead, so these are apparently not the same character, and it's another Elmira situation where the names are similar, but not the same, so I guess they could be cousins? I don't know, but it really messes up everything, because this guy was referred to as Elmer. But whatever, I guess. I mean, this is one of the weirdest discoveries I've had. Another bonus fact that someone mentioned is that his design was to look like his voice actor at the time. Oh yeah, also look, I remade this frame in clay. Isn't that cool? It took a while, so you better look at it for a long time. I'm really drawing this out so you can look at it. New Looney Tunes unaired pilot. There's not a lot on this one, but the original pilot for Wabbit is lost. I think there's a couple clips of it, but the full thing is just nowhere to be found. I found this while reading up on some lost media, and apparently someone tried to get more information about it, but currently there's no updates, and it's still lost. I'm guessing it's held in a file somewhere, or maybe it's just gone forever.
I imagine we didn't really miss that much.
Why? Why would you do that? Why would you do any of that?
Buddy was the second star of the series after Bosco. He was just a little guy, so yeah. I'm glad he wasn't used. Bosco is a funny monkey, so he's unbelievably better. He's not very important to Looney Tunes at all. But Animaniacs, on the other hand, they randomly decide for him to be a villain. Yes, it's not a cameo, it's an actual role, which I find super weird. Just bringing back an old cartoon character so he can play an evil villain? Like, why Buddy? Probably because Bosco was just so good and they couldn't use him. Best part is that I think they literally kill him one time. Like, bro, he's dead. And he committed attempted murder? What? But back to his origins. Apparently the cartoon Buddy's Day Out, it was so bad that they fired the director. So that's just kind of sad. Flash shorts. These are pretty short cartoons animated in Flash. They feature most of the cast. The animation looks fine to me, other than being a bit stiff, but like, who cares, because I get to see Elmer Fudd meet Marvin the Martian.
Are you ready?
Ready for what?
Literally the two best characters. Surprisingly, there's a lot of these, and like, nobody talks about them. There's probably a lot of lore and stuff, like, maybe I can find some. Like, Bugs and Sylvester have weird sons for some reason. Bet you didn't know that. And Granny is a judge, I guess? Elmer Fudd owns a weird farm? Hey look, the Matrix exists. It was all worth it.
Oh, it's that Wesco-y rabbit!
Cool Cat. Sadly, we are not talking about this one.
There he is! Hi, everybody!
Trust me, I can talk about Daddy Derek all day. Look at this smug dude looking like Fanta Pink Panther. His catchphrase is... Apparently, he even had his own theme. I bet it sounds great. He adds nothing. I don't even get this character. What even makes him cool? Who do you work for? Bosco in Tiny Toons. Despite his obscurity, he reappeared in Tiny Toons with his girlfriend. And the names are the same, unlike the rest, so I guess they are just the same characters, but they look totally different. Come on, that isn't a monkey. It's like some weird rabbit. Wait, I got a game theory. There was some girl power message or something in the episode they appear in where Babs Bunny realizes that all the stars are men. Okay, fine. Then Honey does something, and that's the end, I guess. Porky Protagonist. After Bosco and right after Buddy, Porky Pig was the next main character. He would have his disgusting fat design for a bit.
5 pennies, just enough for an ice cream soda.
Come on!
When his smaller design came in, like, every short was Porky. Look, I'm telling you, this design is way more friendly and approachable. I actually like these. If I had to pick out of these three, I'd pick Porky as the main character, and he even stands against Bugs. Also, speaking of Bugs, when he was introduced, Porky fell and became another secondary character. And since he doesn't really fit with Bugs, it was kind of weird to have him in cartoons. But he did show up a bit with Daffy. It's a nice dynamic. They actually brought it back for the HBO series. Scoob and Shag is a webcomic made by Dingo. It features a whole bunch of animated characters, most of them being Looney Tunes, so it counts. It first starts off as this. But then it slowly evolves into this. It's absolutely bonkers. Yosemite Sam is a gunslinging maniac, not much of a difference there. Bugs has the power of TV static, I guess? And Foghorn Leghorn is a Christian. You know, something about that is actually perfect. But you know, there is no Elmer Fudd, so please let him have the power to rocket jump with his shotgun. There are problems with it, like some tones being thrown away, like the bizarre comedy of the first few pages, and the flashbacks are hard to understand, even when it's all laid out in front of you. But I would still recommend it, because I thought I wouldn't liked it, and then I read it, and then
oh
I
my
did.
God, please add Elmer Fudd.
Inky the Caveman. I should have rearranged this thing, because stupid Inky definitely didn't deserve to be on the last entry. He's got the racist stereotype looking character thing going on. I don't know if they meant for it to be a stereotype or not, but you know, that's just what they did, I guess. I don't know. This guy's being hunted by a tiger while he's trying to hunt. It's like some weird bounty hunter thing. There's a circus thing too. A reoccurring character just named Minot Bird, I guess, shows up to trick him or something. But the thing is, he shows up in shows like Tiny Toons, Animaniacs, and Tweety Mysteries as cameos. I don't really know why he did. As for Inky, he officially stopped being used in 1950, basically killing him. But no, that bird gets to survive? Who even remembers him? '30s Porky merchandise. This was just a random suggestion, but when I looked it up, I realized it belongs up here. Elmer Fudd blackface. This is referring to a couple things. There's this Elmer Fudd character who's black hunting bugs. He's basically the same character, but black? This one isn't as bad. It gets worse.
Too bad. Too bad. Oh well.
This is a propaganda thing, and there's our friend Fug Fidmansky. And then randomly Bugs does blackface. Wait, oh my god.
I'm a disgrace to the regiment.
The cartoon fresh hair seems normal, but near the end, well, what do you think happens? You'll Be Sorry was a weird experimental Marvin the Martian movie. Not a lot known is about it, but I believe it's a film where Marvin tries to steal Christmas. I got most of this information from this video, so if you're actually interested in this, go and watch it. It's actually pretty good. This film never made it past test footage, so I'm guessing there was just an unfinished script. Imagine being the poor guy that made that. Looking at the test footage, the first thing that jumps out to me is that this was clearly going to be an awful live-action cartoon movie like Chipmunks or the Smurfs.
You think God stays in heaven because he too lives in fear of what he's created?
I don't know why Hollywood keeps on making these. Cartoon characters put on Earth and gets a human friend to go on adventures with. That's the plot. Also, Marvin looks like the one from Lunatics Unleashed, and that just makes me convulse. It's kind of sad to see this happen to my second favorite Looney Tunes character. But luckily, it didn't happen.
You failed!
The closest thing we have is his appearance in Back in Action, which was actually good. This test footage just shows some Disney Channel kid open a present with a terrifying Marvin in it that has a gun that turns things into ash. Instantly? Wow, so cool. Why are you excited? Can't forget that Marvin was gonna be voiced by Mike Myers. Lost shorts. Early on, it's expected for there to be a lot of shorts lost to time. These are honestly hopeless. It's very unlikely for them to be found. Tapes probably look like this. There are more known lost segments of cartoons. I really don't know how you only lose half a cartoon. Some title cards are lost. The heckling hare has a lost ending, while Hair Ribbon's ending was found. Some more modern stuff is some scenes for Back in Action. You know what they should have done? They should have cut out the weird CGI dog stuff, and they should have put back in Yosemite Sam and Elmer Fudd, but you know, mostly Elmer Fudd. Laugh Riot is the lost pitch to the Looney Tunes show, and it was actually found, and it's public.
The characters don't live in the suburb anymore, and I know not a lot of people like that aspect, but at least it made the show more original. But, you know, they could have still had that stuff, but, you know, keeping Bugs' iconic home and other stuff like that. Another thing is that, unlike the show, Elmer Fudd is actually present, which means 10 out of 10. Then basically chaos breaks loose and every Looney Tunes character shows up, and I don't even know what. Then they're all at Acme and, Orson. Wile E is a clone. This is a fan theory. Wile E. Coyote is constantly called a genius, but why? In every cartoon, he's like dying all the time, failing for simple tricks, so how can he be a genius? Well, he is. The original is, at least.
Hello, Internet! Welcome to Game Theory, where this time, I won't forget gravity. So, for the 8 of you who haven't been paying attention, Fortnite—
He can die so many times in the same cartoon because the original Wile E cloned himself. And those clones have literally— they have no brain.
Being a genius certainly has its advantages.
I do like this theory, but I like this one a bit more. He's a test rat for Acme. He's trying to catch this bird, so Acme supplies him with their products to test them out. This one is better because it isn't confusing. But here's an even better theory. What if it was all taking place in a coma? Porky in Wacky Land is a super strange cartoon. Porky goes to hunt the dodo bird. And this is actually his first appearance. He wasn't in a lot, but, you know, here he is. There's all kind of weirdo stuff here. This guy...
Oh shit, it's a white guy!
Oh my god, is that Cat Dog? I could see a lawsuit here. That's just straight up Cat Dog. Here's my favorite guy, a connected Three Stooges body thing.
Take the stand.
Where did I put it?
No, take the stand.
I got it, now what'll I do with it? Sit down!
Dodo just starts committing a hate crime and Porky's crying from being hit by a brick. That's just kind of sad. You gotta understand that this was to date the craziest Looney Tunes cartoon to come out. It's pretty important. Everyone was like, oh, it can't get weirder. And then this came out. I'm not disputing it. I mean, just look at this stuff. Bugs is killed. I'm sure there's more of this. I mean, just look at the games. Or even Bugs going to jail. I mean, what do you think he did? But in one episode, a man... is destroying Bugs' show by interrupting. So he responds like this. He shoots him! Takes the life of another man! Barely anyone cares. A guy interrupting a show and being dealt with in a drastic way? That kind of reminds me of a certain incident. Old Gray Hair is a pretty old cartoon. It starts off with Elmer Fudd just popping off with the weird turtleneck combo, then... God speaks to him. I'm not joking.
If at first you don't succeed, Elmer.
Is Elmer Fudd like God's first contact? He transports him to the year 2000. And, well, there's some predictions. Let's see if they're right. Okay, looking good so far. Yeah, sure, checks out. We see baby Elmer and Bugs, but like, who cares? Because then it just gets dark. This leads up to Bugs tricking Elmer and burying the old man alive as he cries. Just think about the sentence I just said. That's all, folks, is way more menacing.
And that's fucked up. It's fucked up. It's fucked up. It's fucked up.
Bugs' bathroom. This is about the semi-popular gif of Bugs tapping a toilet for more room. There's not a lot of context on this disturbing thing, but the most I found was that it was a weird ad for whatever this description is trying to say. There's actually more of these videos featuring different people in the stall. Results are similar. This guy and Bugs are trying to get through the door, then a urinal one. It just comes down to creepy Bugs Bunny, but it's not actually referred to as Bugs, so it could just be this guy. Mel Blanc didn't voice all of his characters. Well, not all of his credited voices. In some shorts, he's listed as a character he would usually play, but it's not actually him playing the character. The voice actor isn't credited. It's apparently exploiting some weird credit stuff, and I honestly don't understand, and I don't feel like getting into it. You know, because obviously, you know, Warner Bros. Come down here, you know, knocking down my door, so pretend you didn't hear me say anything. Jasper Goes Hunting is a stop-motion short film made by Madcap Models. There's an old barn, a scarecrow, and some race stuff going on. I feel like somebody's going to mention it if I don't. I find it weird that they changed the entire head and not just the mouth. I've done not good animation. I know a couple things. Am I missing something? It looks better, but like, why would you do that? The scarecrow meets up with the kid and it's like super creepy. He like grabs the gun. They start hunting for... only for this to happen.
Can't get away.
What's up, Doc?
An animated Bugs Bunny comes out, and he's not claymation. He's like also well animated. This special appearance makes no sense, and I don't know what deal had to happen to make this possible. After that, they hang out with some elephants, and that's basically it. Well, we've reached it. The end of the iceberg. Again, I'd like to thank everyone who helped me with the entries. And the script is nearing the end. It was a long journey, so let's dive in. This is an unauthorized cartoon called Rabbit Habit by a man named Steve Peck, who actually made and published the entire thing himself in 1975. The story and characters were written by and acted by a guy named David Grostenstein. It's actually kind of unbelievable. He really animated this entire thing himself. It's not that bad, and it's 8 minutes long. Now let's look at the title screen. What is this cartoon about? Drug use and habit. It's actually the perfect thing to end on. An unauthorized cartoon about a dark topic like drug use and obsession. But there is humor to this. It's already funny to see characters do this, but the cartoon is actually comedic. Elmer Fudd is a drug dealer in New York. Also notice how backgrounds are just real.
I'm your mama, I'm your daddy, I'm your friend down in the alley. I'm your doctor when in need, want some coke, have some weed. I'm your pusher man.
Some businessmen approach him asking for a drug delivery. I love Elmer just like sitting there waiting and playing cards. Elmer goes to find a guy to sell his stuff. He finds Bugs, and let me say, this guy does a great Elmer, but like his Bugs is falling apart, which... you know, it should be in with the context.
What's up, Doc?
Elmer offers him better drugs than the stuff he has. Let me just show you what that drug is.
Wabbit twax.
Rabbit crack. Oh my god, this is glorious. Fudd decides to go back to his route and threatens violence, so, you know, Bugs buys. Look at his face, oh my god. Bugs decides on coke, then we see big development.
Elmer, just the guy I wanted to see! I've been going out of my mind for 2 days! I'm all strung out! If I don't get some Benny, I'm gonna sprout wings!
Daffy is addicted to crack. This explains a lot. I'm sorry for showing everything this has to offer, but like, come on.
Hide me, please. Hide me, quick. Hide me, boys. Yeah, hide me, please.
Quick, Doc, in here!
Bugs does some classic gags while Daffy steals all the drugs. Again, I'm sorry. Bugs just does like way too many drugs, like an absurd amount. So Fudd just shoots it all. A new character joins, Yosemite Sam, who's trying to buy drugs off Daffy. Elmer attempts to take revenge. He does. Then the business guys are back, who mistake Elmer for Porky.
Alright, it's time to hand over the dough, Porky.
Porky, aren't you confusing me with someone else?
Quit stalling, Baldy. Rocco's really sore.
Sam is back and...
blast them! These guys are such a bunch of kidders!
This cartoon is actually a masterpiece. Bugs dresses up as the boss, saving Elmer, which is rare. Daffy throws, I don't know, a meth needle at Elmer, which gets him so high he's in the clouds. Then a monkey shows up. It's great. Now, the cartoon itself is just so perfect and entertaining, but there's actually more to the story. Let me read directly from the YouTube description of an upload by the original creator, Steve Peck. I showed it to Tex Avery in 1975, when he was 80, and he loved it, and he said, I wish I had a job to give you. Showed it to Chuck Jones. He was very conservative and did not like what I had done to his characters. It turns out he actually showed it to some major players in Looney Tunes history. One of them loving it, the other hating it. But hey, it got a huge laugh at festivals, and at the end of the day, probably the most interesting story I've heard in a long time. Well, that's it. The Looney Tunes iceberg made by me with a lot of help from others. So it's basically their iceberg. So let's just show them all. And you know, it really helped because I would not know. I would have to go through a lot of stuff that I didn't know about to find, you know, really interesting topics. And they actually came at me with stuff I could research and then put in here and then make this process way faster. And iceberg is already dead, but you know, whatever. Also, I'm glad the Eminem video did well. Hopefully a lot of people see this one because, you know, it's not a joke. And I actually researched a bunch of stuff and put some interesting topics in. And I'm proud of this video. And thank you for watching. That's all, comrades.